let's just grant the possibility that there is a creator God who's omniscient, who occasionally authors books. And he's going to give us a book, the most useful book. He's a loving God. He's a compassionate God. And he's going to give us a guide to life. He's got a scribe. The scribe's going to write it down. What's going to be in that book? I mean, just think of how good a book would be if it were authored by an omniscient deity.
Well, with an omniscient and omnipotent God in mind, we're going to look around the world and compare the books that deal with the divine. And we should probably look for the widest distributed, best-selling, most published, most translated, most quoted book in the history of the world. Do you know which book holds that title? Well, if you didn't already know, that book is the Bible. In order to understand the level of its useful influence to the fullest extent, one needs to look no further than one of the most secular areas of society, pop culture. Over the centuries, starting in the Middle East and moving over to the Western world, and back around the world, the Bible has formed the very backbone of pop culture. If you go to any major art museum, you will soon recognize the strong biblical influence in what you see hanging on the walls, or even what you see standing on its own. Whether it be made to celebrate or denigrate, there's no denying the strong Bible base of the art world. This goes for literature as well. If you look back at the authors of the past, the ones who have influenced the authors of today, you're going to find strong roots to the Bible. You're going to see direct quotes from the Bible, important selected words, or concepts used to create the author's own original work. What would happen to this work if the Bible never existed? Now, one might argue that today's pop culture is much different. One might think that the modern pop culture age is so far removed from the Bible, has even claimed that it no longer finds the Bible useful, that it must be completely free of any biblical influence, right? Well, let's take a look to see how useful the Bible is. Think about the smallest example, OMG. Now, what does this widely used text message abbreviation stand for? Well, it stands for Oh My God. Now, one might make the claim that this could be referring to the God of any other religion, but when you take everything in context, it's actually quite easy to narrow down the choices to see which God the statement is actually referring to.
Jesus Christ!
Jesus Christ!
Jesus Christ!
Jesus Christ!
Jesus, what happened to your face?
I knew it.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus of Nazareth.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Did you hear that?
Jesus.
Jesus, you know, it's all kind of Jesus coming back everywhere.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
How you can give your heart to Jesus.
Jesus Christ!
Jesus Christ!
Jesus!
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 Jesus
Christ!
Jesus!
You said it, man.
Well, isn't that interesting? It seems that one specific name is being used very heavily in modern secular language. And you can find this name in the most unlikely places.
Paul Robia. But my friends used to call me Jesus. Your pick.
I'm sure it's by complete accident that he's standing there holding his arms like that while calling himself Jesus. And you know, even if you look at the most popular memes on the internet, once again you're going to see this key name pop up.
Jesus Christ, that's Jason Bourne.
People on the internet have taken this in all different directions, but the way things are looking, I'm surprised that this isn't one of the meme variations.
Jesus Christ, that's Jesus Christ, that's Jesus Christ.
It's starting to seem like Jesus is the hidden Easter egg in all the media, even popping up in video games like Grand Theft Auto V. What a coincidence that the big pop culture Easter egg is Jesus. Along with this name, if you just look at the titles of some of the mainstream movies, you're also going to find a lot of biblical language in plain sight. Even when it comes to horror movies, you still require the Bible to sustain them. Movies such as the Matrix series wouldn't even exist without the Bible, as many of the names and concepts from the movie are borrowed directly from the Bible. Neo, like many other similar figures in movies, TV, literature, also shares a particular title description given to that specific character type, the Christ figure. Now, who do you think that's based on? When it comes to figures like Superman, they don't even hide the fact that this character also pulls from the Bible.
Now, people marketing the movie Man of Steel are heavily targeting Christians.
They're offering Christian groups free screenings as well as sermon notes that highlight Superman's similarities to Jesus.
When it comes to other popular movie franchises, many of these are also rooted in the Bible. If you didn't know this, the character of Aslan in the Chronicles of Narnia series is actually based on Jesus Christ. And believe it or not, even the Harry Potter series borrows from Christianity. Which is kind of odd since the Bible doesn't really speak in good terms about practicing magic or sorcery. Going in a completely different direction, you're even going to see the Bible rooted in things like professional wrestling.
Talk about your Psalms, talk about John 3:16. Austin 3:16 says, I just whipped your ass.
This catchphrase is quite a lot different than what John 3:16 says, but even so, seems that the WWE owes its millions of dollars made in Austin 3:16 merchandise to the Bible. Professional wrestling has even used storylines in the past such as this.
In the kingdom of heaven, please welcome God.
And of course, they even hold events that contain biblical words like hell in a cell. And even there, it's possible to hear some religious dialogue.
Jesus Christ!
Moving away from this area, it seems that even other fellow YouTubers rely on the Bible for content. For example, the popular YouTube Miranda Sings character constantly references sin, Jesus Christ, and other Christian terms in her videos.
Dear Lord, please be with this woman. She is of sin. Satan has grasped a hold on her.
And you can see biblical influence once again with the YouTubers Grace Helbig, Hannah Hart, and Mamrie Hart, as they have been dubbed by their fans as the Holy Trinity of YouTube. So, even in this area, the Bible is still required to produce some original content. Isn't that right, YouTubers?
Are you Jesus?
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus took the wheel.
Dancing with Jesus,
a hologram book.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Think of like Jesus or whatever, right? So Jesus died and Jesus would come back.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is still Jesus even though it's been 2,000 years.
When it comes to the world of comedy, things are no different. Comedian Russell Brand has recently had a world tour entitled Messiah Complex. And even comics who really bash religion, like Sarah Silverman, still require the Bible to produce the titles of their own specials. When it comes to other comedians, once again you're going to find a strong biblical base within the comedy scene.
I do want everyone to feel comfortable. That's why I'd like to talk to you about Jesus.
Jesus Christ! What a great name, Joe!
Thank Jesus!
Jesus Christ!
Jesus said, O ye of little faith.
Jesus, read me!
Jesus is magic!
Jesus.
Now, Jesus.
Jesus is the Lamb.
The death and resurrection of Jesus.
There's Jesus, there's Jesus, there's Jesus, there's Jesus, there's Jesus.
He was like, Jesus, please help.
Have you had many Jesus auditions?
I treat my entire life as a Jesus audition, Dave.
I am Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Supposing I drive a nail and I miss it and hit my thumbnail. I don't mean this is a blasphemous statement. The guy says, Jesus Christ! He never says Buddha.
And now we approach the music scene. And can you guess who we're gonna find in the lyrics?
Who was it, everybody? It was Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Prepare yourself, you know it's a must.
Street. Are you ready to meet Jesus? Are you ready?
Jesus round her neck.
Got Jesus on my necklace.
Got to blame it on Jesus.
Hail Mary to the city of a virgin. Jesus can't save you. Life starts with the church.
But they ain't even think Jesus when he died on the cross.
They say you can rap about anything except for Jesus.
Jesus is my virtue. And Judas is the demon I cling to.
The last clip of Lady Gaga comes from her song Judas, which obviously stems from the Bible. Likewise, a number of her other songs also pull heavily from the Bible. Simply read the lyrics and the songs off her album Born This Way and see for yourself. She is far from alone though, because many different artists of all genres constantly use biblical keywords and concepts. Keep your ears open and you'll hear words like sin, hell, holy, heaven, angel, idol, salvation, prayer, Lord, God, Jesus Christ, on and on. If you take into consideration that the Bible clearly states that God is love, then you could make a case for all love songs to be rooted in the Bible as well. Going past this, even bands like Nirvana, which takes its name from a completely different religion, still uses Christian symbols to get a rise out of people.
Hey, wait, I gotta move away.
They aren't alone though, as you will constantly see Christian symbols and concepts placed in the music scene. Are you starting to realize the true source behind our creativity and our entertainment?
Christ is the first celebrity and all entertainment comes from religion.
Seems to be true, don't you think? It's even the case that some rebellious bands pull from the Bible in order to make their case.
I am an Antichrist! I am an Antichrist!
This Sex Pistols song claims the title of an Antichrist, and this could possibly be true because the Bible says that there are many of them, although only one who is THE Antichrist. The whole lure of hell really seems to have hooked many songwriters, as you can choose to drive on highway to hell, fly in like a bat out of hell, or get there by thinking you can actually buy a stairway to heaven. Perhaps it's because you have too much sympathy for the devil. This all stems from being a sinner. Is this the way Jesus walks? Take even two recently deceased pop stars, David Bowie and Prince. Bowie's last album, Black Star, featured a track called Lazarus, a key biblical name, and it even talks about him being up in heaven.
Look up here, I'm in heaven.
And of course, there's the title track, and I wonder what this scene in the music video is alluding to. When it comes to Prince, the fact of the matter is that his music is deeply rooted in the Bible. If you didn't know already, Purple Rain is about God's coming judgment on earth, right before the second coming of Jesus, where blue sky mixed with red fire and blood makes purple rain. If you want this confirmed, just look at this lyric from the track 1999 on his 1982 album of the same name. What's even more interesting about the Purple Rain album was that the B-side of that title track was a song called God, which recounts the creation story of Genesis in the Bible. Even the song Let's Go Crazy is rooted in the Bible, as was explained shortly after Prince's death.
Let's go crazy.
Yeah.
And it says, don't let the elevator bring us down. One time when I was with him privately, he said, well, the elevator is the devil.
If you're aware of Prince's lyrics at all, none of this should be a surprise.
What's the difference between life and death? God.
There is no other king. There is no other king. Only Jesus Christ.
So the reality is that without the Bible, there would be no Purple Rain album, and also a large part of Prince's entire catalog would be gone. When you look closely at the lyrics of other artists, you're going to find that a lot of your favorite songs would disappear with the Bible as well. The fact of the matter is that the Bible is such a strong foundation in the world, that even secular pop culture requires it in order to exist, even if a large portion of it is used to denigrate Jesus and the Bible. And what mainstream influential force would want to spend money doing that?
Could it be Satan?
The fact remains that Jesus' name and other biblical keywords are being spread around the globe, because it's the Western pop culture that actively moves around it. So, just from pop culture, you should now be able to see why the Bible is such a powerful book. No other book is so borrowed from, and even if it's constantly put down by those who borrow from it, at the end of the day, Jesus is still getting his name implanted into the minds of the global population every day. If this name has this much power in secular culture, then it might be wise to investigate exactly what that power is. What you're going to find is the truth, and the truth is Jesus. And even though pop culture might tell you different, you need to know that the weight of the truth means life, and that we need to listen when the truth speaks.